Hello, welcome. My name is Carmel. Today I'm going to talk about the best VS Code extensions in the year 2024 web development. Woohoo! Oh, 2020, what a year, right? The first extension is called Prettier. Prettier automatically formats your code for you. So you have some random spaces or your line of code, it's just like going on and on and on. It'll break it up for you. To download Prettier, head over to the extensions tab, type in Prettier, and then just click install. After that, go to your settings. On Mac, it's preferences settings, and it'll open up that UI. Type in format on save and click on that checkbox so that when you go to a random file and you enter in some random spaces and press save, it should automatically just get rid of those spaces for you. The second extension is called Eslint. Eslint is, I think, typically more known for being an NPM package. If you don't know what NPM is or what Node is, it's just a package manager so that you can install various libraries that do cool things. Download ESLint the same way you downloaded Prettier, and then open up your settings and click on this button in the upper right-hand corner. It'll say opensettings.json. Head over to the link, I'll put it down below, but copy my settings that I put on GitHub for you and just paste it in, and that should automatically just like import some ESLint rules for you to follow. And then if you ever want to install rules later on in your application or just across your computer overall, you can add rules to that rules object in settings.json. So if you go to the documentation and you see these like random rules and you're like, what do I do with this object? Just remember that you can go to settings.json and then try and play around there with whatever you need to fix. Maybe there's a warning that's coming up and you don't know why it's there. So don't forget that, okay? Then the last extension is called GitLens, one of my top favorite Git extensions, because whenever you're looking at code, you can see the last commit message on that line of code. And so this is really useful for when you're working on teams, especially just so you can like get some context about like, okay, when was this code made? Like in what context did this person write it? And hopefully the person wrote some useful information in their commit message. Sometimes they don't. But it's also useful to see like what you put as your commit messages in the past. So that's why I really enjoy GitLens and why I think you should download it too. So those are my three extensions that are my favorite on VS Code right now. If this video helped you, don't forget to like and subscribe and comment below with any extensions that you think I should try out, because I'm always down to make VS Code do everything for me. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in another video. Have a good one.